Showing off your wealth used to be considered vulgar.
I wouldn't say it's showing off, I would say you've got it, flaunt it.
Now, with the help of social media, today's youngest generation of super rich have practically made it a sport.
Pictures speak like a thousand words. It's work hard and party hard kind of a lifestyle.
Inside the boot of the car, we've done like a custom bar.
From selfies on super yachts to posing with private jets, these are the rich kids of Instagram.
I probably spend around $15,000 a month on just shopping.
My parents flew me off to Fiji for a month just because I was bored.
But with all the distractions money can buy, why do they bother flaunting their fabulous wealth for the world to see?
I didn't really have that many followers when I first started. You know, it became addictive and I just kept posting photos of my life.
At a single click, I could spread a message to 24,000 people instantly.
Normal is not fun. That's why I gotta make it dynamic on Instagram.
If I'm showing off, what are you gonna do about it? Are you gonna come and stop me?
Sometimes when it's too busy, we'll take a helicopter, like if we want to go to Cannes or like Saint-Tropez for lunch or something, just to avoid all the traffic.
20-year-old Lana is a multi-million pound heiress who spends her time jetting between family homes in New York, London, Ibiza and Monaco.
There isn't really anywhere else like Monaco. I mean, almost every square mile is like beautiful. It's quite exclusive. I mean, you'll get like the best cars here, like all the nicest things. And it's got great buildings. It kind of reminds me of Disneyland. I love coming to this particular shopping mall in Monaco. It's got all my favorite designers. So I'm wearing a Hermes Birkin bag today, and I'm wearing Louis Vuitton boots today. So they're like my two favorite designers for shoes and bags. I got this actually when I got really good grades. This bag would be about £25,000 to £30,000. I'm not just sure exactly how much it is because my parents bought it for me, but yeah. I had another one which I graffiti sprayed by accident. So my parents were mad about that. It wasn't really an accident though. It was kind of like, I just felt like doing it. I probably spend around $15,000 a month on just shopping.
What do you think the average person spends a month on shopping?
I think the average person a month spends on shopping around like $3,000 to $5,000.
The opulent lifestyle of the world's wealthiest 1% has always held a fascination for those aspiring to join their elite club. Today's young generation of super rich can now feed this fascination by uploading images with the tap of a finger. 20-year-old internet entrepreneur Evan has been designing phone apps since the age of 12. He's made enough money to take helicopter rides like most people take taxis.
One of the services that I have is that I press a button, it's Ubercopter essentially. It's like Uber for helicopters. You press a button and they give you a helicopter 5 minutes away from you. It's more of a necessity. I just need it every day to get from one point to another.
I mean, it's one of the best ways to have a look at LA because you can see the Hollywood sign, you can see Santa Monica Pier, Venice Beach.
Evan's Instagram account currently has over 120,000 followers. He has no idea who most of them are, but he knows what they like.
I like to post about what I'm doing. I go to clubs and maybe spend $20,000 a night on alcohol or charter a yacht for $50,000 a day. I'm not really staging a show. If I'm having fun, I take a photo and I post it. Pictures speak like a thousand words.
Though Evan's playboy antics attract a whole army of followers, not all of them are fans.
Oh yeah, definitely. I have a lot of haters. I mean, there's no doubt about that. Haters don't pay bills, right? I mean, someone's gonna pay for me for my helicopter or my yacht. I'll be happy to listen to them. But otherwise, I could give one less fuck about them.
Once branded a rich kid of Instagram, abuse is never far away. But that still doesn't stop them posting.
I don't care. When I post things, it's just like, whatever. If I post something obnoxious, I do it kind of as a joke. And it's like, if you're going to give me negative responses, I feel like, just unfollow me. Like, I don't need you as a friend.
...22-year-old Timothy comes from a family that made its fortune in diamonds, and he has only ever known a decadent lifestyle.
Shopping and spas and lip injections. I've been getting Botox since I was 14.
When he's not at the family home in Palm Beach, Timothy enjoys frequent shopping trips to Europe.
Is it exclusive?
Yeah.
Is this exclusive to Europe? This is all ostrich, and then this is hand beaded. The only thing is, when you walk, it kind of leaves a trail of feathers. Gorgeous. Oh, it's gorgeous. I pretty much have the top two rows.
You prefer shopping for yourself or for other people?
For myself.
How would you describe your background?
I guess money was really never talked about. It was just kind of there. I guess I'm still growing up and I'm still learning and this and that, so I am more carefree when it comes to spending and, you know, buying things. I was here October and November. I spent an obscene amount staying at the presidential suite in every single hotel, you know, 25 to, you know, 40,000 euros a night for about 3 weeks. That adds up. I try to get my mother to have a few cocktails before I show her the bill, but the American Express bill can be quite interesting, I guess you could say.
Capturing your wealth on camera for the world to see has become the quickest way of showing you've made it.
Who is here?
You can count
him.
Start
it. Okay.
Today, entrepreneur Evan has organized a yacht party in Los Angeles. With money to burn, finding company is just a few clicks away.
My idea of partying is basically having a great time. I'm going to be with a great group of people. I love to go on yachts. That's one of my favorite things to do.
Okay, touch it. Oh, yeah, you got it, you got it.
I know that I want a certain level of luxury that I'm able to pay for, so I definitely want that for myself. I don't want to be going to a club and standing 20 minutes at a bar to buy a girl a drink. I want to have 10 bottles in front of me and maybe 10 girls already waiting.
Do some dirty shit. Come on, twerk your ass.
$15, three guys, it's a good ratio.
How have you managed to get it for that ratio?
I have so many girls hitting me up, I don't need to hit them up. So yeah. Just like, if I post a picture about on Instagram, yacht party at 3 o'clock in LA, I'll get like maybe 20 girls texting me in 1 hour. Can I come, can I come, can I come?
So a lot of the people that come on the yacht, you've never met them before?
No, that's true. I've never met half the girls on this yacht.
Oh my God, what the fuck?
You've not met Evan before today?
No, I haven't met him before today.
There we go. How do you like having champagne sprayed on you?
It was fun.
Why is it guys do that?
I guess they like to see us get wet. I don't know.
Though Instagram helps him find friends in every port, Evan struggles with the more conventional relationships.
some people feel uncomfortable with your relationship with girls.
I won't really have a relationship with one girl right now. It's impossible because I travel extensively. I've not met anyone who's able to keep up with me.
So the kind of relationships you have at the moment, how long do they last?
I don't have relationships at the moment. I just meet and I make friends and I go away. Like, that's it. I haven't had a relationship since I was in high school. So yeah.
The rich were once discreet with their spending, but many of this generation's young and privileged can't stop projecting their fabulous lives to the entire world.
In some ways, I suppose I've always wanted to write a journal of my life, but in some senses, I'm quite lazy. So it's a good platform for me to document my life.
Everything that's on my Instagram, that's what I encounter every day. That's how I live.
I'm showcasing my interest in fashion. It's different than just showing off.
When 20-year-old Lana moved to America to study, she became a familiar face on the elite party scene. A multi-million pound heiress, Lana's Instagram postings suggest a carefree, privileged lifestyle.
I actually blocked my mum, like, on my personal account once because I knew that she was always looking at my photos and she didn't really like what I was posting.
I don't like Instagram, not a fan at all. The only reason why I have it is so that I can keep an eye on my daughters and see where they are, what they're doing. I have thoughts of the dangers of having Instagram. You don't know who your followers are. You don't know who's looking into your life. My daughter has a big social following, actors, sports people. She's in that little clique of inverted commas celebrity. You know, there are a lot of other people who are envious of that. Obviously, there's always somebody that's going to try and put you down.
Having 22,000 followers doesn't necessarily mean you're popular, as Lana found out to her cost. After an MTV awards party, a snap she posted with entertainer Robin Thicke went global when the mirror behind them revealed the married singer's hand up Lana's skirt. The aftermath put pressure on Thicke's marriage and caused a barrage of online abuse aimed at Lana.
So my mom saw all the comments, obviously, while I was away in LA, and she obviously didn't like me getting hated comments on my Instagram, so she went on my Instagram and deleted the account. Yeah.
She was angry because she'd had a lot of followers, because it's so important to have a lot of followers. But when I asked her who are the followers, she didn't know. And that's the issue.
I didn't really have that many followers when I first started, so I was kind of, you know, it became addictive and I just kept posting photos of my life.
30 odd years ago when internet didn't exist, and my life was wonderful. I mean, comparing it to today, great. You know, it was instead of WhatsApp and, you know, it was pick up the phone and say hi and have a conversation, and you would see how that person felt on the day, you would hear their voice. It was lovely to hear somebody's voice. You know, it's all about typing a few things nowadays. When you say rich kids of Instagram and glam, how much of that is real? It's a fantasy.
One of the tools that can help create a fantasy online life is the selfie.
I'm no psychologist, but in some ways, I mean, if somebody's taking 10 photos of themselves every day looking for confirmation that they're good or surfing or searching for likes, there's got to be some negativity to that.
36-year-old Sammy from Southeast London uses his selfies as a way of capturing his luxurious lifestyle for posterity.
I see Instagram as my canvas. If I was an artist, I would like to paint the picture of my life.
As well as images of his worldly travels, Sammy's other favorite subject is his four-wheeled pride and joy.
I wouldn't say it's showing off. I would say, as my late mum told me, if you've got it, flaunt it.
So one of the features that I designed with this car was that inside the boot of the car, we've done like a custom bar. So inside, we have the champagne glasses, then we've got exotic champagne, a couple more bottles of champagne in case you're thirsty. We've got the Cristal 1988, we've got the Ace of Spades. And inside here, we've got some more drinks if you need it, some cognac, some brandy. On the roof, we have starlight headlining with 2,500 stars.
Is your shirt
colour
coordinated to the car?
Today, I colour coordinated the shirt to the car today. I feel like a right c-
Though part of a huge online army flaunting boys' toys, entrepreneur Sammy tries to remain grounded.
What I feel separates me is I try and keep it real. I mean, a lot of people just post super nice stuff, stuff that isn't theirs, pretty stuff. You know, everything I post is my photos. It's real. It's real life. There's no bullshit. There's no fakeness. It is what it is. So there's too many people out there, I feel, you know, trying to sugarcoat Instagram to be the perfect world.
Good morning. Double pie, double mash. Take away, please.
Take away, sweetheart.
Yes, please.
I wasn't born with a silver spoon in my mouth. I mean, I wasn't handing down anything.
Yeah. Cheers, darling.
And my dad's a London taxi driver. My success really came from the property market and the boom of the early 2000s.
To show he hasn't forgotten his humble beginnings, Sammy likes to post pictures that have a generous helping of his working-class roots.
In my heart and my soul, it just feels right to maybe show the people who I've met around the world that this is a part of my heritage, this is a part of my upbringing, this is a part of me.
The double pie, the double mash, sitting on the Rolls Royce, snapped it, got it, posted it.
But for some Instagrammers, staying grounded is the last thing on their mind.
There's a fine balance of keeping it real. There's a crossover, there's a border of where it becomes vulgar and excessive. For me, maybe showing hard cash.
Even within this posturing world, there's a point when showing too much becomes taboo. But for some people, breaking the rules is part of the game.
I'm so retro, I still got a flip phone. Hello? Yeah, where you at? I'm at home listening to music. What about you?
When it comes to flashing the cash, one of Instagram's most prolific offenders goes by the name of Cash Fleazy.
I feel like Cash Fleazy is just like the second side of me. That would be weird to show in real life. But it's because of social media I'm able to do this.
Cash Fleazy is the alter ego of 21-year-old Nathaniel, a wealthy student living in San Francisco.
It's like definitely putting on a mask and getting ready. Yeah, it's almost like an avatar, like a character that exists within me. You know, it's like a little switch. When I'm on Instagram, I turn on that switch, I'm Cash Fleazy. Turn it off, I'm just a normal boy.
With a taste for the world's most expensive designer brands, Nathaniel attracts a heap of online abuse. The Cash Fleazy persona is designed to provoke his haters even more.
I do get a lot of hate comments. At first, it kind of hurt, like, when people say things. But now my perspective changed to let's go feed the haters instead of dealing with them. So I would post more material to make them hate me more.
One of the trends for wealthy youngsters on Instagram is to suggest good taste by carefully arranging displays of luxury brands.
number one thing that the haters hate is the cash. So that would be number one. Add some cash to the video or picture. And number two, how I post it, like the arrangements and how the picture will look at the end. I'll just lay it somewhere in a very creative way. Make sure the logos are showing. And then I'll probably get a wad of cash and like stick it in the back pocket. Credit card, which is a piece of plastic. But then if you have a wad of cash, you can see how much it's piled up. You can hear it when you're counting it. And it's just more, you know, artistic and dynamic. For this particular picture, the key is my jeans. Limited edition Dolce & Gabbana jeans. All the plates are 24 karat gold plated. So then once I got my setup, I will try to get like a good angle, get a good lighting. I think it's the ultimate way to show wealth.
It's not just an excuse to show off.
I think it's a way to show off without me feeling guilty too, because it's all on social media. And like, if I'm in everyone's face in real life, they're just gonna like hate me.
Nathaniel's girlfriend, Linda, is often recruited to lend a hand with cash-fleazy video postings. She's been assisting Nathaniel for nearly 2 years.
What is this? Use your fingers.
See, I'm not the professional at this. Just like another form of expressing himself. Maybe it's just a phase, I don't know. Just something he enjoys doing, so I support it.
Can you shower for me? After I take the video, I look over it, and then it's done. There we go. I just posted 3 likes already. California is in a drought right now, so I'm gonna try to save on the water bill. So can you shower for me?
Just explain where the wealth comes from.
It was my grandparents who were wealthy through real estate. And then my grandfather made enough money that after my parents had me, they've just been living the life. None of my parents work anymore, and they just relax all day.
Do you think you're gonna be like that?
Unfortunately not. I'm the third generation, and I'm the one who has to work in the future. Because, you know, just because we had the money back then, and we've been living off inheritance for like the past 20 years. I never asked my parents about bank accounts and stuff, but it's gonna run out.
With more than 400 million users on Instagram, it takes something special to get noticed. But post the right material and your followers will grow.
To be honest, I didn't think people would be interested in my life because every day I'm just taking photos of my life.
It's funny because I get negative responses from people that have never met me.
At the moment, I'm in top 10, top 15 most followed Instagram accounts in Kazakhstan.
The oil-rich nation of Kazakhstan is experiencing something of an economic boom.
So here we have my watch and cufflinks collection. This is Frank Mueller, Rolex, Audemars Piguet. This one, for example, is a more casual watch. So we've got the spinning turbine here. This one is actually a limited erotic edition. This is our living room, a tiger here, and that's our dog, Safi. A second living room, which is not used very often. This is where the sun tanning goes on. I have a little jacuzzi here. Music playing and the view, you know.
20-year-old Dimash is part of the country's new wave of wealthy youngsters. The son of a successful businessman, he is studying psychology and entrepreneurship.
I have 24,000 followers at the moment, which is quite good for Kazakhstan.
insta-famous.
Right, in a way you could say that. I'm I am in a way insta-famous in Kazakhstan, and it's, you know, it's growing every day. Just recently I've been out in the city and I had a few people coming up to me and asking to take a picture, funnily enough, as if I was a celebrity, you know?
Dimash attracts followers to his Instagram page by curating an image of the model gentleman of his generation.
Okay, I'm just gonna go after you.
Yeah, sure, follow me.
Just take some pictures and stuff.
We're going up to the mountains. It's called Chimblak. We're gonna have a little drive around and also hopefully take some good pictures. This is a 911 Turbo, my most favorite car. Does the shot look good?
Looks good.
Yeah. Usually, you know, for a man in a suit, a good shot would make, you know, fixing a cufflink, for example, looking at the watch, just, you know, kind of adjusting that, and so yeah. Our whole city of Almaty, the way it works is the higher up you go, usually the nicer it is. Как думаешь, нормально такой ракурс?
Попробуем несколько.
When people become popular on Instagram, the number of followers often grows rapidly.
Look on the side, look there.
This newfound popularity can be intoxicating.
It's exciting because I just like the fact that at a single click, within a second, I could spread a message to 24,000 people instantly.
Where's this one?
Just a bit closer up. The more people kind of talk about you and look at you and follow you and they start getting a voice, people start listening to you, listening to what you have to say as opposed to, you know, just any average person. I know I have a lot of young followers from my country who, in a way, look up to me. And, you know, that kind of gives you power.
Social media networks have fast become powerful marketing tools. And for the individual looking for exposure, it's never been easier. 25-year-old student Ezra lives in New York's fashionable Greenwich Village. Supported by his parents, Ezra lives alone in a four-story townhouse.
This is my formal living room. Why? To match my outfit. My kitchen. I don't really cook much, so.
This is my puppy. His name is Charlie.
Ezra uses Instagram to highlight his love of designer clothes. This includes a personal collection worth over £500,000 in shoes and handbags alone.
I like my shoes sparkly. You can see. So I love like small bags, all clutches actually. Like this is actually one of my very favorite Keygun. It's a little badass. It comes in a sequin form, which is like still very me. A dictionary clutch. It looks like a book, but it is a clutch. I love these ones. I think this is the last one that I got not too long ago. It's very sensitive and it's very high maintenance. It looks like a milk carton, but it's actually like a bag and you can actually put like decent amount of like things inside.
So the milk carton look, is that still in?
I think it definitely still in.
The son of an Indonesian real estate tycoon, Ezra is expected one day to work for the family business. But Ezra has other ideas.
I'm studying business finance. I was just trying to pursue what my parents wanted me to pursue. But since I love fashion and I have a deep passion for fashion, I would love to merge what I've been studying and what I'm actually passionate about. If I don't make it in fashion, then I would end up working for my parents. We should take photos now.
To avoid moving back to Asia, Ezra is using social media to forge a niche in the fashion industry.
today we're going to Soho. We're going downtown New York. I love like taking photos in the streets of New York. It's very like urban. Yeah, I'm excited.
For 6 months, Ezra has been building a portfolio showcasing combinations of his favorite designs.
Once a week, we're trying to take like few photos, different outfits, like, you know, minimum like two, a couple, or three.
And do you get funny looks at all?
Yeah. Like some people compliment, some would just like, you know, like stare and like give me like all the weird look, but I don't care. I like it.
What's this outfit all about?
I'm trying to channel my inner New York. The dark side, I have to say.
Ezra's pictures will be uploaded to Instagram and his website to draw followers to the Ezra brand.
What do you think your brand is? What is your brand?
I guess it's just me. Oh, that's very nice, actually.
If you're building a brand to sell something, what's the product?
Nowadays, I think it's vice versa. You got to brand yourself first and start making a name for yourself. And as you go along, you start creating products. And I think that's what a lot of people do, like, I mean, nowadays, branding themselves.
Branding yourself on social media is a modern-day obsession. But once your image is out there, controlling your brand can be problematic.
Hi, how are you?
20-year-old millionaireess Lana had her name dragged through the mud following that compromising picture with singer Robin Thicke.
Okay, this doesn't want to stand up.
Despite the PR disaster, Lana's now launching her own jewellery line.
This evening is all about promoting my new online store. I've got about three of my main pieces on display over there, which is like my trademark with the gun. I've got friends from all over coming. Unfortunately, my Saudi Arab friends can't make it because it's Ramadan.
Oh, it's Friday.
Hi,
Kate.
Probably another month or so.
I've done some professional ones for like Rihanna and Drake with crocodile and snake like around.
Yeah, I'm really proud of her. Even like setting it up for herself is a big step. Being from someone who had like not the best press to someone who's, you know, trying to turn it around and have a bit of an entrepreneurship, trying to show people that, you know, she isn't the person, you know, spoiling people's marriages, and this isn't, you know, the Robin Thicke girl, and she's, you know, she's actually trying to benefit herself.
I'm 20 and I've made a lot of mistakes. I've realized that when you're selling a product, you're also selling yourself. So I don't want my business to get dragged down by my past.
Lana's fledgling business is funded by her father, and she's hoping not to disappoint him again.
It's kind of scary because I've never really been out there by myself. I know that like my dad will always support me whatever if I ever need help, but I'm just trying to, you know, go on my own road and do everything by myself rather than just relying on him.
To climb the ranks of Kazakhstan's Instagram elite, Dimash must decide which picture will bring him the most followers.
Usually I just go through the batch of pictures that I have, and then, you know, one by one I'll be removing the ones I don't like for sure. I would crop it to make it a square for Instagram, you know, kind of tweak with the light a bit, at which point I'll upload the picture.
What makes that a good picture?
I don't know, I just like my position, you know, I like my facial expression. It looks pretty easy, casual, you know. I like the angle of the picture as well.
The images suggest that you've achieved something. Why do you think you should be a good role model for young people?
Okay, yeah, you know, success is also, success and achievement, it's, you know, it's relative things. For example, it's not like I'm a CEO of a big company and that's my achievement. No, it's more about, you know, the overall way that I am. You know, the way it works on my Instagram, you know, I'd be dressed well in front of a nice car, you know. But the most important thing is what I'm writing beneath it.
By combining pictures with words of wisdom, Dimash aims to leave more than just a superficial impression on his followers.
Here's an example. I have a recent picture of mine here. The caption that I put there, I'll read it out to you, is: "Nothing can stop the man with the right mental attitude from achieving his goal. Nothing on earth can help the man with the wrong mental attitude." I get many private messages every day, and they tell me, "Look, I've been reading stuff that you write. It really changed me, you know, changed the way I think about life. It just really warms my heart thinking that, you know, helping somebody in some kind of way."
Dimash's privileged lifestyle is possible thanks to his parents, who worked hard through Kazakhstan's tumultuous breakup with the Soviet Union.
Who's the biggest role model in your life?
That would definitely be my father. I just, you know, ever since my childhood, I know the kind of person he is, the kind of man he is. He started with nothing, basically, you know, and he worked his way up, you know, through hard work.
Does your father think you're a good role model?
Any parent would like a child who's taking his studies seriously, you know. It's kind of a present to every parent, you know. So he said yes. It's the first time he says all these things with me being here, you know. It's actually true, because,
you know. Because it's not in my rules to sit here and say, you'd be a girl,
maybe, yeah. So because it's not part of his rules, you know, to kind of be here and, you know, give me these, like, compliments and stuff. It's just, you know.
One of Kazakhstan's biggest social events of the year will give Dimash another chance to impress his followers, the annual Opera Ball.
The ball has been going on since 2008, so I've been hearing about it. Now they've kind of reorganized the whole event, so now it's becoming even more exciting, even bigger.
As well as a great photo opportunity, the ball offers Dimash the chance to meet the star host, Miss Universe, a role model with a truly global following.
She's got around 1 million followers. She's, you know, an example for many women, and I want to be a bit of a role model for the young generation of Kazakhstan, so it's very exciting to meet a person like that.
Though Dimash has perfected his online image, real-world situations can prove more tricky.
I just need a moment to... Wait, my phone is there. There's this one particular very, very tricky part about tying a bow tie. So I have to consult the instructions again. Did I mention I'm a perfectionist?
Yay, we're here.
If fashion enthusiast Ezra doesn't find his niche in the industry soon, he'll have to work for his family's real estate business in Indonesia.
That's cute. I can see you in that.
Cute. So cute.
How much?
1800. It's couture.
With the help of social media, he's been raising his profile to establish a brand.
Cute. Isn't this cute with this brand?
Super cute. You have to try.
How could Ezra make money in the fashion industry?
Oh, there's all kinds of ways. I think I could see him starting his own company one day. He loves accessories and he loves clothes.
Is it too much or no?
They're amazing.
Is it very Miley Cyrus of me?
They're so Miley Cyrus. I think she wore them, actually. He also could make money through, you know, his blog, maybe reviving a brand that has been, you know, around for a long time. The lines between the different roles in this industry are very, like, blurred.
Also assisting the building of Brand Ezra is friend Ben, who works in advertising. Mm-hmm.
Yeah. No music on the website, no.
No, why? It's tacky.
Max. There's a lot of people building their own websites, trying to build their own brand, especially in New York City. New York is a city of dreams, isn't it? And where dreams die or where dreams become reality. What's on your top list to buy?
My own top list to buy this season would be the kangaroo loafers with the one it comes in two colors, like the fur. It's a black loafers. I think I uploaded the photos on Instagram. The cycle of fashion changes really fast. You just have to be very strategic with what you wear and not like wait too long, or else people will be over it and people will just move on to the next thing. I'll be carrying on my Victorian Bohemian look just because I don't really follow the trend.
We all know that. So I think we have what we need for the next two posts.
Even without a product to sell, the images that make up Brand Ezra seem to be attracting attention.
Ezra, within 5 months, upped his followers by almost 10,000.
He's cute, right?
Mm-hmm. Before there's Instagram, before there was web design, there was TV. People followed what they saw. But now with platforms like Instagram, Snapchat, I don't need the media telling people what I am. I can just show them what I am. Social media is the thing to do or the place to be.
The place to be tonight in Kazakhstan is the prestigious annual Opera Ball. The event has attracted some of the country's most affluent members of society, including popular Instagrammer Dimash.
So we just walked in, you know, and you could straight away sense the atmosphere. It's really nice, everyone's dressed up, everyone's in a good mood, you know, everyone's looking forward to the night.
Featuring Kazakhstan's finest opera singers and musicians, the ball is also a rites of passage for some 60 pairs of young debutantes. Keeping with tradition, the debutantes encourage guests to participate in at least one dance. Despite some false steps on the dance floor, Dimash's more polished online presence has gained him celebrity status.
I was invited a few times to dance by some of the girl debutants, and you know, as we were dancing, we had a little chat as well, and turns out that they know me from Instagram and they recognize me. It's very interesting how it works, you know. It's quite a big city. We have 1.5 million people living in the city, and yet I meet so many people who follow my Instagram and, you know who I am. Feels great.
As one of Kazakhstan's most Insta-famous young bachelors, Dimash has managed to negotiate a meeting with the evening's star host.
So I spoke to some people and I managed to get a little face-to-face encounter with the Miss Universe, so it would be nice to chat with her.
With the prospect of meeting a role model with over 1 million Instagram followers, Dimash is determined to make a good impression.
Welcome to her humble abode right. For the evening.
That's really nice.
Are you sweating?
A bit, yeah.
Okay, stop it. They
greet people differently in different countries, so you know I just don't want to be, don't want to come across as rude when I greet her. So how do you do it in Colombia? Do you know by any chance?
You want to practice on me?
Sure.
Is it the wait, how old are you?
20.
Okay. Well, come on, Ed. Come on. Right.
Yeah.
Okay. So you're gonna see her and
yep.
Two cheeks.
Okay. Great.
Okay. You
yeah.
Like that?
Yeah. Sure.
And you could come a little closer.
Okay,
I can. I know you're sweating and everything.
It's all right.
And,
all right. Yeah, sure. No problem.
I'm gonna bring her out for you.
Hi.
Hello.
Hi. How are you?
I'm pretty good, yeah.
Nice my name to is meet Mike. You. What is your name?
Dimash. Dimash, yeah. You're Polina. Polina, right?
Yes.
Yeah, right. How does it feel to be a role model to so many girls, you know? How does it feel to have so many... Complicated.
Yeah, but it's a big opportunity to try to help. Yeah.
I think the same way. I think it's great to, you know, to have people look up to you and kind of you setting an example for them, right?
Exactly.
So it's
you
great.
You need to be careful.
Right, you have to be careful what you say and what you, yeah.
But
same.
I think that you need to be authentic, but also be careful. You know?
Exactly, that's exactly what I think.
Looking like a prom shot.
I know.
It's very funny how, you know, her words kind of echoed mine. When you have so many people looking at you, you know, and so many people looking up to you, you really have to, you know, be careful of what effect you have on them.
An encounter with one of the world's most beautiful women is guaranteed to give Dimash more followers than ever.
So we took some selfies and I'll have a look at them and I'm quite sure I'll post one of them, you know.
In a world where sharing our lives is easier than ever, the rich kids of Instagram phenomena will continue for as long as their followers demand it. Or at least, until the money runs out.
How would you cope if all the money disappeared?
It would be bad.
That's very, it's very scary, actually, to think about it.
There's a point where you have to realize in life that it's not all about what you've got. It's about living life and enjoying it.
I don't think I could ever be a waiter or like a cleaning person in a hotel.
Me and my friends joke. They say like, if I ever go broke, you still have like 30, 40 Hermes bags you can sell and you can probably live off of that.
I could never be a gardener or construction worker. Nothing really that is hands-on labor.
How do you become Insta-famous and what does it mean anyway? Find out how to give your online life a reality check at channel4.com/am I normal. Tattoo Fixers back for a new series on E4 tomorrow and there's a fresh face on the team. Meet the captivating Alice at 9. Electrifying drama here on Channel 4 next tonight. Joyful and devastating, the final part of Fargo. Coming up.